By the end of this video, you will know how to handle your micromanager boss. I'm Van Bradshaw and I'm a career coach for highly sensitive people. In this channel, we talk about tips and tricks so that you can thrive in your career and in your life. Let's get started. The number one step is you gotta figure out what kind of micromanaging style your boss has. So usually there are two types of, there are three types of micromanagers out there. One is someone who tells you how to do things, exactly how to do things. And number two is this person wants to be on the loop on everything. Or number three, if you're the lucky one, it's all of the above. Usually it's all of the above. And I can tell you, I've had many micromanager bosses. I've had bosses that are not micromanagers. When I first started out becoming a manager, I was at some point was a micromanager. So I have many experiences about people micromanaging me. And what I can tell you is that this is the first way and the only way that worked for me in order to work with my micromanager boss without losing my sanity. It is, I will actually go against the grain here by saying you have to learn their pattern. You have to learn which kind of micromanager your boss is. Usually it's a combination of three, but usually one is a stronger trait than the other. If your micromanager boss wants you to tell him or her exactly where you are, what you're doing at what moment, I would say just anticipate or look for the pattern of their behavior. You're a highly sensitive person. You can see these patterns. You can read people and you can feel what kind of emotions they have for a certain day. And I tell you, all micromanagers have a pattern. One of my micromanager before is he wants to know exactly what I'm doing in a certain project. And from time to time, he would sprinkle, like tell me what to do exactly, what color or what kind of spreadsheet he wants to see presented to our client. But more than that, he wants me to tell him exactly the status of the project I'm working with at that moment. And the reason for this is that he used to be me. He used to be doing my role and then he moved up to a new role that he is not very familiar with and he's figuring that out while he knows exactly what to do in the current role or that role that I had. So there's two things here. Number one is he's a little insecure with his new role, the new role that he is doing, and also he feels that he can do my role at that time with his eyes closed. And so in order for him to feel good about his job, his career, his place in the company, he was micromanaging me. And it was very annoying and very discouraging and frustrating at that time. But I quickly learned his habits. I quickly learned how to work with his micromanaging style, his micromanaging tendencies. And I stopped looking at him as the bad person that many of us, when we're being micromanaged, label our bosses. But really, he is just an insecure guy because he moved up and he's fairly new in his current role. So what I did and what I advise you to do is that he wants to be kept on the loop. So what I did is every time I would come back from a team meeting that he used to be on and now I'm the one representing the company to those clients, I would go by his desk or his office and give him a 2-minute update of what happened. And then at the end of the day, every 4 p.m., 4:30 p.m., he and all the other clients will receive a status email from me. Same format, same time, same everything. So once I started doing those things, he stopped micromanaging me in that way. He started trusting me and trusting his part in that company. So if you have a micromanager boss who tends to ask you every small detail about your project, then I advise you to do the same thing. They have a pattern, and all you have to do is set aside that frustration, that, you know, like, disappointment or any negative emotions you're feeling about yourself Don't personalize it. It's not about you. It's not that you're incompetent. It's not that he's incompetent. It is a big ball of emotions that your boss is not capable of handling at that time. But you are capable of handling it. You're a highly sensitive person. You can work your way through those emotions if you pay attention to the right emotions that are productive at that time. It's okay to feel the negative emotions. Let it be. Let it go, but use the productive emotions that you can see. They can't see it, but you can. So use that. Use that as a superpower, like what I like to say it. So number two is almost similar to number one, but in a way that this is going to be in person. So number two is schedule a recurring meeting with your boss. I like to do it every week. I like to do a quick recurring meeting with him or with a micromanager every week, and then one major one every month. And I always say that over communication is the key to micromanagers, because they just want to know. They want to know what's happening, and they want to know what kind of value they are providing to you and the company. Most of the time, micromanagers, like what I said, are insecure in their current role. They might not know it. They will not say it to you, but you know. And a secure person, someone who does more than you, will never look over your shoulder and look at the color of your column or your spreadsheet or ask you what you're doing at a certain time. So number two is very quick. Just put it in the calendar. Just have a recurring meeting with him or with her, monthly, weekly, and you will be good. Like, they will leave you alone, at least for a moment, or they will not be as a micromanager as they are when you're avoiding them, when you're trying not to communicate with them, because it's very annoying to be micromanaged. When I first became a team leader back in Accenture, I used to work for Accenture. I had a phase where I was micromanaging someone because I don't know what that person is doing. I'm the opposite. I never did what he was doing, so I want to know what kind of role he's doing. So because of that goal I had in mind to know what he's doing, it was kind of borderline micromanaging. And so, was I insecure? Yeah, a part of me was, because I don't know what he was doing. Like, I want my bosses to go through me and not to him, because I felt at that time a little irrelevant. So in terms of managing that person, I had my own tasks. So when I learned what he was doing, I stepped back. So if your boss is micromanaging you, if you're new, this could be one of the reasons. Along with recurring meeting, I would advise you to set up an expectation meeting. What is an expectation meeting? Basically, that's just the word. That meeting is where you set expectations of the job, the task that you're given. And also, you ask your manager what their expectations of you. Many times, micromanagement in a team is purely miscommunication. Even though you're over communicating, they probably are not understanding you. So expectation meetings, recurring meetings are a place, or it's a place, it's a forum, it's where you, both of you, can clarify things that might be missed in terms of the daily tasks that both of you are doing. Number three, and this takes a lot of guts, and if you're one of the lucky ones that have a micromanager boss who likes to tell you exactly what to do, who also asks you to tell him where you are at your project that you're working on, and they are not backing down even though you did all the number one and number two, this is when you have to be a little brave and set them aside in the meeting and ask them, "You are micromanaging me. Tell me what you want from me. I don't want you micromanaging me." If this is something that you can do respectfully and professionally without being emotional in a room, it's very important to do that, because sometimes your boss doesn't know that they're micromanaging you. Sometimes it takes one person to speak up to this micromanager and tell them, "Hey, you're micromanaging me, and it's not healthy for me, for my career, for my personal life. I'm losing sleep over this because I don't like to be micromanaged." And I've seen this happen. I had a coworker. We had a micromanager boss at that time. He assigned all of the tasks to us. He had this big meeting, and he had assigned task 1, 2, 3, 4 to each of us. And then, so we agreed, we understood everything. And then what he did was to send a calendar invite or like a reminder to all of us teammates on when the deadline is, what the milestones for each of those tasks are, and when he wants to know the status, which is okay. That's what he wants to do, but not everybody wants that. I didn't mind it. I didn't care. I don't care if he was micromanaging me, but one of my coworkers didn't like that. So he was very emotional at that point, but he told my boss that, hey, I don't like being micromanaged this way. This is not how I can focus in my work. I don't need this. And he stopped doing that to him. He didn't stop doing it to everybody, but my point is, you have to tell them that you are being micromanaged and that micromanaging doesn't work for you. For other employees, micromanaging is fine because they want to be told what to do. They like that. They like to have their hands held. But if that's not you and you're in this video because you don't want that, tell your boss they are micromanaging you, and you have to be brave and prepared to give them evidences of micromanaging. So those are the three tips that I have for you to deal with your micromanager boss. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below or to any of my socials. I also have a Facebook group called The Meaningful Profession for Highly Sensitive People. In this Facebook group, I give tips and tricks that I don't share in any other platform. It's just exclusively for the members of that group. I am so honored that you're here. You stayed through the end. I will see you guys again next time.